You know, this body is such a unique body. It's amazing. It is amazing. All right, it's 12:25.
Are you dismissing the kids for me?
Yes, kids can go to children's church. All right, you guys okay?
Yeah.
If we do something here?
All right.
Isaiah 43:14-22 is where we're at. I've been asking the whole time, Lord, do I even preach this today, the way things are going? But I feel like today is a perfect day for this. Because something has shifted today in the atmosphere, in each one of us individually. A lot of times we've sensed things shift as a church, but today I felt like something shifted in individuals as we anointed, as we prayed, as the Holy Spirit was kind of swirling and breaking through around here. So this is Isaiah writing. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sake, I have sent to Babylon, and I will bring them all down as fugitives, even the Chaldeans, into the ships in which they rejoice. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. So remember, Babylon's always been an enemy to Israel. And the Chaldeans were eventually incorporated as part of the Babylonian people. So a lot of times, over time, the reference to Babylonians also included the Chaldeans as well. So they were enemies. So what is God saying here? It says, thus the Lord your Redeemer, for your sake I have sent to Babylon and will bring them down as fugitives. God is doing battle for us. He is battling those who are our enemies, who come against us. Babylon actually means gate of God, lowercase g. In other words, paganism, gate of false gods. It's a counterfeit of God's eternal kingdom. It is an opposition to God's rule, things that come against what God is trying to do, what God is moving in, what God is working in and trying to break through. So what he's saying is God is going to tear down those things. And that, I believe, is a prophetic word for us today. God is going to do battle to break apart and tear down things that have been hindering us from moving forward. The things that have been our enemy is coming down. Which leaves one thing. God is removing the obstacles that have been there from the past. The things that were hindering us from moving forward and succeeding. He's going to tear them apart. To battle, put them back in their ships and send them home. Removing them from our path. Then he goes on in verse 16. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way through the sea and a path through the mighty waters, who brings forth chariot and a horse and the army and the mighty men. They will lie down together and not rise again. In other words, his army is going to take down their army completely and not be an obstacle to you anymore. They have been quenched and extinguished like a wick, just like a candle wick being blown out. Their fire is done. Their impact is done. Their fire is gone because holy fire has quenched it. Holy fire has torn it apart. It is gone in the name of Jesus. So if your enemy, your physical enemy, your physical obstacle is gone, what is left from keeping you from moving forward? What obstacle is left? Because he's laying the framework of his parameters, right? What he will do, what he's willing to do for us. This is his job. He did this. He removed the physical obstacles from our way to move forward and torn down the thing that would burn. So if there's nothing left in the physical nature in front of us to keep us from moving forward, what's left? Up here. If the physical object is gone, what's left is the mental block. It's our mindset. Because a lot of times, there's nothing physically hindering us from moving forward, but it's our own minds that are stuck somewhere that keeps us from pressing in and moving forward. So this is what he says to do, verse 18 now. Do not call to mind the former things or ponder things of the past. He's telling Israel, do not let the thoughts and memories of the past hold you back from moving forward. Don't let those traumatic memories, those traumatic experiences, those things that were always there, that are no longer there, be as if they are still there. Don't let them get in your way. Their past obstacles will no longer be an issue. So don't hold on to them. And those traumatic experiences or those thoughts that he's talking about, because it's not limited to traumatic experiences, they also include the lies of the enemy. The lies you can't. Well, if you're telling yourself, I can't, even the thing that's in front of you that you thought you couldn't conquer, you're still saying, I can't, even though it's not there, then yes, you're not going to be able to. I've accepted the lie that I can't. So now I paralyze myself from moving forward. At the last men's roundtable, one of the phrases that we kind of talked about was paralysis by analysis. Overthinking things and how that kind of stumps you from stopping, from moving forward. Sometimes we just got to say, it's gone in faith. I'm pressing into it and not overthink it, not limit our thought process from moving forward. I cannot see the new thing God is doing when I am being blocked mentally, emotionally, by getting stuck on the old thoughts. Bible talks about old wine is for old wineskin. When God is doing something new with new wine, the only thing that can hold the new wine is new wineskin. The old wineskin is too worn out to hold the new wine. So if God is pouring out new wine, we need to get the new wineskin of our hearts, bodies, minds, everything ready to hold on and receive the new wine. And he is doing a new thing. And the whole focus of today's word is this new thing that God is doing. You know, be recognizing when God is moving in our life in this new thing. And he says this now in verse 19. He says, don't think about the old. In verse 18, do not call to mind the former things or ponder things of the past. Don't let them be your stumbling block any longer. Don't let them be your chains anymore. Don't let them be your shackles anymore. Don't let them be the thing that's keeping you back. Instead, in verse 19, behold, I will do something new. I'm not doing it. He is saying, I will do something new. Now it will spring forth. Will you be aware of it? In other words, I'm doing it, but are you going to get it? Are you going to see it? Are you going to engage in it? Are you going to be a part of it? Are you going to be able to come alongside me with this new thing? Even recognize that there's something new going on, that the old is gone, that things have shifted, that we're moving forward. The old way is not sufficient for what's coming ahead of us. Will you be aware of it? I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, okay? I will clear a path where there has never been a path before. Rivers in the desert. So just think about this one, the two things God is declaring he will do. In this new thing, where you thought there was no way, God makes a way. And when we talk about a desert, we're talking about a place that there is no life in. Rivers of living water will flow. Life-giving waters will flow in a place where there had no life before. Where there was death, now there is life. Where there was nothingness, now there is something nourishing, nurturing, growing, moving, changing. Something is coming alive where it was dead in our lives. In this new thing, nurturing will take place. New life will be established where there is no, where there was no life before. There was nothing there. A new road, a new path is going to be created in this wilderness, because the wilderness represents confusion. So God is removing the confusion, creating a path. And his word says, he's a light to our path and a lamp to our feet, right? He's doing this. And he's not only creating that path, he's bringing life to the road that we travel on, that we will move with him on. Life is being established. Rivers of living water are going to spring up. And where there is living water, there is life that will flourish in that. It will sustain. But the key thing here is we can't change with the change if we can't recognize the change. Get that? We can't change with the change that God is doing. We can't move in this new thing if we don't recognize that things are changing, that he has changed. If he's removed the physical obstacles out of our path, the only thing that's left then is me. Will I get in my own way? Will my mindset, my attitude, my fears, my insecurities, my doubts get in my own way? Will my lack of faith in what he's doing get in my own way? Guys, the last 2 years being here, I'll be honest with you, it's been the most challenging times of my life in ministry. It's never been more stressful and difficult. And I've said this a couple times before. I'm supposed to provide direction and leadership, but I don't know where I'm going half the time. And it scares me to death, especially someone like me who likes everything in order. Okay? I like to know where my next step is going to land. Right now, I don't know. All I know is every day, Holy Spirit's picking one foot up and placing it somewhere. That's all I know right now. But I see something happening, but I don't know what it looks like. But I know God is doing something new every day, every way. I don't get it. As a church, we've done our best to imitate and be the way the church was established in the New Testament. The very best we can. We're not perfect. This is what God told us to do, and that's what we're trying to do. As an individual, I can see God stirring things in the spirit, moving in people's lives in new ways, and moving in my life, in our family's life, in a new way. I don't know what it's going to look like tomorrow, but I know, okay, this is what I'm supposed to do today. So I need to shift the way I think about today away from the way I thought about yesterday. Because yesterday is done, okay? Yesterday is done. So Lord, what is this path you're carving in today's wilderness for me? And where is this river that's teeming with life being established in today's desert? Because it's still a desert if my mind thinks of it as a desert. But when my mind says, Lord, what are you doing? Open my spiritual eyes. Reveal yourself to me today that I can flow and just be in your lazy river. Because that's the ideal, right? Being able to float on that round little floaty in his lazy river, flowing with him. That's life. Help me to see what you are doing. Break me of the mindset of the old. And that's hard for me because I'm a traditionalist personally. I love things the way they used to be. I love consistency. But if I don't see the changes that God is doing and don't come again alongside his changes and recognize them, I will never change. Things will never change. So one of our prayers needs to be, Lord, what is the new thing you're doing today? He says, behold, I will do something new, and I will remove the things of the old that were in your way yesterday. They're not going to be in your way today. So now get yourself out of your own way. Get yourself out of these old mindsets. Get yourself out of the old attitudes. You know, one of the things the enemy uses against me personally is, so my wife is wanting to shift, and she feels a shift of the Holy Spirit in something. And this thing within me goes, but this is the way I've always been all my life. Well, and then I go, whoa, that's, wow, something, I need to change that. It's okay to change that. And I don't like change personally. But I need to learn to be okay with the changes that God is doing. We need to be okay with the changes that God is doing. Where are you shifting, God? Because with change, there's tension. But again, the anointing on the change allows us to flow even within the tension. But we need to get out of our own way. He's removed the physical. Now, Lord, remove this obstacle. Remove what's in your way within me right now, within my heart, within my attitude. Because he ends this by saying, the beasts of the field will glorify me, the jackals and the ostriches, because I have given waters in the wilderness. I have given waters in the wilderness and rivers in the desert to give drink to my chosen people. The people whom I formed for myself will declare my praise. He makes a distinction between his chosen people and the life that will also be sustained by the fact that these things are happening. In other words, this change, this new thing God is doing, not only is about us, but it affects those who we come in touch with, right? When I change, it affects the atmosphere and the temperature in my home. When I change, it affects the atmosphere and the temperature in my workplace. As I change, it affects how I interact with people in the community. As I change and I'm willing to go outside of myself, life around me becomes nurtured. Every single person that was testified about last week and today about the encounter that took place in Red Bank last week, because those individuals that went came alongside the new thing that God was doing, because many of whom may have never done that before, God created a path. And he brought living water through the desert. Everyone at a park, on the street, got something that nurtured their soul from it, that was spoken to, that was prayed over, that was touched. But it all has to do with one person saying yes. Every single person in this church that said yes to stepping out, whether it is in an official capacity or filling in and preaching or doing something, it's not just about you. It touches every single person here. It affects us all. When one of us grows, they bring back the area of growth and breathe new life into everyone else. That's what's exciting. That's what's so exciting about what God is doing, this new thing. But we will never come alongside and get with his program, with this new thing he's doing, if we keep getting in our own way. So would you stand with me now? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Just position yourself to receive right now. Thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, just come. And for those that is on Facebook as well, just come to their homes where they are today. We just first say thank you for removing every physical barrier that has impeded us in the past. And Father, we thank you that the timing of how, of when you removed them was perfect in step with our spiritual growth. Because not every obstacle is from the devil. Sometimes God just holds us back a little bit because we're not ready for the next phase. He's just like the boundaries we set with a child. Our loving dad, it's for the child's sake, sets the boundaries for us. But when the time comes, he breaks through. So thank you, Jesus, for sending your armies to remove what's kept us from moving forward in the past. And now you are creating, Lord, for us a pathway in each one of our wilderness and a river teeming with life in each one of our deserts, Lord God. So Father, help us to renew our minds right now. Just come, Holy Spirit. Let the blood of Jesus wash away the old. Wash away the old. This is what I'm seeing right now. If you ever turn on a sink that hasn't worked in a while, or with old pipes, at first, the water that comes out is a little dark, it's dirty, might even be rusty. But then as it runs, it's clear and it becomes pure. And what I'm seeing now is as the blood of Jesus is washing through, because he's washing away the stuff, I'm seeing the dirt come out first. But then I'm seeing the purity of the cleansing. So Lord, thank you for what you're cleansing, Lord. Thank you. Thank you for washing us with your blood, and what you're leaving is pure. Thank you. So just receive right now. He's changing your mindset. He's changing your attitude. Things that you've said, I can't. Things that have said, there's no way. Things that you've looked at and seen and just didn't even think about because you're like, it's just locked. The Lord is opening up right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Anthony Allison, I feel like what you're doing with your house, it's going to start to kind of quicken the pace because it's going to go smoother. So, Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let it flow. Let it flow. Open up the new thing. New thing. And one way we come in an agreement is we stop speaking death over these things. And when I say speaking death, speaking like as if it can't happen. But let our words now come into agreement with the new thing that it will happen. It is happening because he is doing it. So Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just release that. Set that free, Lord. Yeah. Thank you, Lord, for more. Just cleanse our minds, our thoughts, and let the mouth come into agreement with what you're doing, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm not sure who's listening right now on YouTube, I mean on Facebook, whether you're listening live or you will listen later, but I'm sensing a spirit of frustration that's coming through the screen, and in Jesus' name, I just release his peace over you and the ability to renew your mind in his peace, in his flowing river, because whatever you're dealing with, the Lord is just going to wash that clean and just wash you in his peace right now. His peace, Lord, come, come, come right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, thank you. Yeah, Lord, thank you. Guys, Jesus paid the price on the cross for this to happen. It is in his blood this happens. It is in the power of his blood and in his love. And he's doing this because he loves his sons and daughters. It is the blood of Jesus. So we just thank you, Lord, for your blood that covers all these things. Jesus is the Word of God. The Word became flesh. And his Word says, renew your minds with the washing of the Word. So let, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the power of the Word, wash our minds clean right now.
There's a family who had an argument, and the enemy's using the argument to try to break the family apart, and using it as a foothold, Jesus will just dissolve the argument. The argument's not going to have any power to destroy the family, because Jesus will dissolve the argument, and you cannot let the enemy use the argument to tear your family apart, and it means nothing. Nothing. You have to take authority over the argument. Holy Spirit is strengthening the family and will restore that family. It's not worth pulling the family apart over a stupid argument. Do not let the enemy take that foothold.
Amen. Amen. What Amanda just declared, for those on Facebook, I'll paraphrase real quick. There's an argument. The enemy's using an argument within a family to try to separate and destroy this family. And Holy Spirit's not going to let that happen. In Jesus' name. So we thank you, Lord, and we bless this family in the name of Jesus. Thank you that you work all things for the good for those who love you and are called according to your purpose. And we just declare that this family is called according to your purpose because they are loved by you, and because you love them first, they can love you. So thank you, Jesus, for bringing full restoration to this in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you're releasing. More, Lord. More, Lord. More, Lord. More, Lord. Just listening to Holy Spirit, what he wants to do next as we get ready to close in a minute. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the new thing you're doing right now. And thank you that you have given every one of us right now. You've opened up our spiritual eyes to see, in our spiritual ears to hear. Jesus, how many times said to his disciples, those that have ears, let them hear. Those who have eyes, let them see. And he also said many who are not hearing or seeing. And they're trying to listen, but they're not getting it. Thank you, Lord. Though in your anointing right now, we are able to see and hear. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. I'm seeing eardrums being popped right now, and people hearing. I'm seeing scales falling off of people's eyes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I'm seeing arrows going into hearts, like the arrow of God, just knowing, piercing the heart. Thank you, Lord. Yes. More, Lord. More. He's bringing clarity to situations. More, Lord. Bless them. Bless them in the name of Jesus. Yeah. All right. I'm just going to leave it here right now. You guys stay with Jesus as long as you need to. And Father, I just bless each one here today. Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in their lives, Lord. The new thing that is taking place in Jesus' name. When you are released, you're free to go. But stay with him till he releases you.